In today's video, I will redesign this mobile app UI design and I will make it great, explaining how and why along the way. As you can see, it's some sort of a real estate app concept. Let's start with the first screen. The biggest problem, which is visible straight away, is definitely the color contrast. Not only those grays are too dim on white background, but even button labels and primary color don't pass WCAG lowest standards. That's why the first thing I decided to do is to generate a completely new color palette based on the original primary color that passes all of the WCAG color contrast standards. Next thing that you probably noticed already are the text inputs. On the original design, they resemble old material design inputs, and there is a reason why in 2017 Google changed them. As it turns out, the line affordance under text field was not clear to some users. The line was confused with a divider. The label and input were confused with body text, especially in dense compositions. That's why I decided to replace them with inputs that don't have those issues. Next thing I want to focus your attention on is the context of the primary action. On the original design, we are clearly logging into the app, but the sign-in button is presented as a secondary action. That's why in my design I decided to switch them, so the context of the primary action is represented properly. Last thing I did was more of a marketing change. Since this is definitely a presentation piece, where the goal is to present designer skills, it's always a good idea to make it more attractive. Addition of the service logo gives the project identity. Then I made a bit more space to expand the nice background photo a bit, as well as making the service slogan more prominent. Now, let's move to the next screen. As you saw on the previous one, the biggest change is around color contrast. On the original design, you can barely see some of the UI elements, so it would definitely affect accessibility. So, as on the previous screen, I applied my new color palette to fix that. Next thing I did was to expand the search input. On the original design, the filtering icon is outside of it, which makes the whole area visually unbalanced. Since the filtering clearly applies to searching, why not to include it inside the field and allow the whole component to fit better with other elements of the interface? Most likely you notice that I replaced the original photos. Reason for that is very simple. I would describe the selection of the original ones a bit questionable. As I described in my past videos, good photos can elevate any project, especially the presentational one. Not only that, but we want to make sure that it matches the representation. If we are talking about the apartment, let's show the apartment, not the house. Apart from those, I fixed the visibility of the liked offers. By adding the white background, I achieved visibility no matter what is behind it. And in the context of app like this, you can expect diverse and complicated backgrounds. Next, I fixed and unified distances between the elements, which not only allowed me to add some more options like wardrobe icon, but the whole design looks more balanced thanks to that. Then we have the navigation, which cuts out in a very weird way on the original design. Why not to add some shadow and gradient behind it to better separate it from the content? The gradient also has a secondary purpose. It's indicated to the user that there are more options on the list, so it encourages scrolling down. I also added the fourth option in the navigation, primarily because I thought that only three options looked a bit weird, but I figured from the last screen that we also could have notifications in an app like this. The last thing I didn't mention is the slight change to the background. Instead of using white, I went for a very slight shade of gray to make the interface elements pop out a bit better. Let's move to the third screen. All of the mentioned changes applies to this one as well. Apart from that, the primary change deals with the bottom part. First, I reworked the copy a bit because the original one was kinda weird. Also, instead of using read more, I opted for gradient collapse. The idea is that the user can expand the description by tapping at the text. Next, I removed the buy now button because that is very unlikely that the user would be able to purchase property through the app. It's more of a listing than e-commerce. So I combined the call to action with the agent section, where the purpose of it is to be able to contact him or her. The addition here is the change of photo from the original design. We have a guy in the baseball hat, which doesn't really build trust in the context of app like this. That's why I replace it with a more professional one. The last thing is the removal of section labels. All of the sections are self-explanatory, so to reduce the noise, I removed them. That's it for today. If you like this type of content, please watch more of my videos here.